Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain three methods based on grabbers, insert and delete operation on multi-array, and those are related to data structure and algorithm implementation within C language. So if you want to watch algorithms on all three operations, so for that you can go to description of this video. And you can find a link of playlist related to data structures and algorithm. Also, programs, those are implemented using C related to DS, right? So first I'm going to implement a method that will be doing traverse operation on multi-array. So return type is void. Name of method is traverse, and it will be receiving two arguments. First is array, and second is its size. So now, with the help of this size, we can display all the elements which are available into this array, and this method will be called by the main function. So from main function, we are going to pass array and its size. So I am declaring one variable array. Then I am going to implement a loop. So it will start from 0 and it will go up to less than n. And inside this loop, I can print value of array using k of I. So this way, this is a simple implementation how we can print elements of array one by one, that is known as traversing of n, right? So this implementation is using C. So here I have explained you like how we can implement algorithm using C language. So I hope you understood this. Now I'm going to explain second one, that is related to insert operation. So that is our second operation. So right now we are going to understand how we can insert an element on a particular position of VGL. So return type event, function name will be insert, and it will be having total four arguments. So first is array, second is size, third is the position where we want to insert the element, and fourth will be the item that we want to insert. Right, so these four parameters will be passed from the main function. So now I am going to declare one variable, that is I, and it will be having value as n minus 1. Now I am going to implement a while loop. So here I am going to check this condition. If I is greater than or equals to k, then this loop will repeat. Right, so here n is total size of array. K is the position where we need to insert the element, and item is the value that will be inserted. So now, with this, I am going to shift the current position of current value of array to the next position, so that the required position can be blank and we can insert the new item. And here I am decrementing it. After completion of this loop, I can write t of k equals to item, n equals to n plus 1, and I am returning the modified size of array. Right? And remember one thing, this array we didn't return, because whenever this insert function will be called from main function, so main will be passing an array that will be received into this array. And in C language, if you modify the array in a particular function, so the caller of the function array will be modified automatically. So here in this insert function, we are going to modify this array. So the main function array will be modified automatically. So we just need to return the modified size of the array. Now, let's understand it with an example. So let's say this is our array. And these are five elements, those are already stored in the array. So now I am going to take a value. So let's say size of n is 5, so n is 5, 8 is 2, item that we are going to insert is 20. So now starting from this first step, so I will be n minus 1. So value of I will be 4. Check this condition, it is true. 4 is greater than or equals to 2. So A of I will be assigned into A of I plus 1 position. So I is 4. So A of 4 position value will be assigned into my 5th position. So it is shifted to 1 place. Then I will be decremented, so it will be 3. 3 is greater than or equals to 2. So A of 3 position will go to A of 4 position. So 14 will go here. So 14 is also shifted. Now I will be decremented. So I is 2. So 2 is greater than or equals to 2. Condition is again 2. So A of 2 position will go to A of 3. So 13 will shift here. Right? And I will be decremented. So this time I is 1. So this condition is false. After completion of this loop, A of K position will be having item. So A of K, K is 2. So the second index will be having new value, that is 20. So all three values are shifted to right hand side so that we can insert a value on this position. And after inserting that particular value, you can see initially size of n was 5 and right now the size of n is 6. So that's why we incremented it by 1 and we are returning it to main function that will be calling this insert function. So this way I hope you understood how we can implement insert function with the help of C language. And if you want to watch how we can write algorithm related to insert operation, so again go to description of this video. You will find a link of playlist that is data structure and algorithm. So in that playlist you will find one video related to implementation of traverse, insert and delete algorithms related to 1DNs. Right now after this implementation, next is deletion. So I am erasing these. So now we need to understand the deletion function. So that will be the third. So in case of deletion, again we need to write this method. So return type is in. Function name is delete, and again delete function will be having four parameters. So first is array, second is size, third is the position from which we need to delete the element, and fourth is the item in which we will be storing the deleted element, right? So here, first of all, I am going to declare a variable in which I am assigning a value of k. Then I am writing while I. So a condition will be while I less than n. So inside this loop, I am going to write the stat a of I equals to. So if I will be having a of I plus 1 value. So this time you can see we are inserting a right hand side value to the left hand side position. And here I am writing I plus plus. Right? And we can write n equals to n minus 1. And return n. And if you want to store that element that is deleted, so here you can write item equals to a of k. So the k position element will be stored into item, and let's say you want to show a message printf / n. %d is deleted and you can print it like this. So the value of item will be displayed here. So the value is deleted, message will be printed. Right? So this way it is implemented. Now I am taking example. So this was the array that we created, and after insertion 20 was there, right? So now we need to pass these values. So let's say n is 6, k is 2, and item variable. When we start here, start from here, so I will be equals to k, so it will be 2. Then item will be equals to a of k, so a of k is 20. So item will be having 20, so that will be displayed here. Now we need to check this loop. So if I is less than n, so value of I 2, it is less than n 2, so a of I plus 1 will be assigned to a of I position. So I is 2, so this position will be erased and its next element will be assigned here. So this time we are shifting elements from right hand side to left hand side. Then I will be implemented, so it is 3. Again it is 2, 3 is less than 6. So a of 3 position will be having a value which is available on a of 4 position. So it will be shifted here. Then again I will be implemented, so this time I is 4. So 4 is again less than n. So a of 4 will be having value of a of 5 position. So this will be shifted here. And I will be again implemented. So I is now 5. So 5 is again less than 6. So a of 5 will be having value of a 6 position. So here we need to put n minus 1, because right now you can see value of I is 5. So if we take n as 6, so one more rotation will be performed. So it will be shifting this position value to here, that is of no use. So here you can put n minus 1, so it will be 5. Right now I is 5, so 5 less than 5 will be false. Then you can decrease actual value of n, so it will be 5. And this printf will be printing value of item, that is 20, so 20 is deleted. So here you can see right now we need this array. So n is decreased to 5, so total 5 elements are there. So new value of n will be returned to the main function, and whenever this modified array will be printed, so in that case traverse will be printing total 5 elements, 6 elements will not be deleted. So this is basically drawback of array. The physical notation is not deleted, the value is still there. We need to manage the increase or decrease size both in case of insert and delete operation. So with this way, I hope you understood how we can define methods related to traverse, insert and delete operation. And if you want to watch how we can implement their algorithms, so go to description of this video. So you will find a link of playlist that is to write data structures and algorithm. So watch those videos available in that playlist so that you can understand how we can write algorithms. And this was implementation of those algorithms with C language. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.